Larry Holmes, boxing's undefeated heavyweight champion for over 5 years. Larry Holmes, a boxing legend. Pennsylvania is Larry Holmes' hometown, and his presence is everywhere. At the Holmes residence, host Jane Kennedy talks with Larry about his early days.
Now, Larry, what about your childhood? I think at one time your mother said that you were basically a street fighter.
Yes, I were. You had to grow up kind of fast, especially back in the days. Things change a lot now. Most kids didn't have anything to do, so we hung out in the corners and we did whatever we had to do to survive.
Did you really think you had a chance at a career in boxing?
No, I didn't think so at the time. I got in the fight game to make some money, not to be rich, not to become a champion, but just to make some money so that I didn't have to struggle for the rest of my life. But after I got into the game and worked with Joe Frazier, been around Ali and Foreman and Norton and the guys, and realized their age was much older than me, and I was doing pretty good there. So what would happen when they would get old and retire, and I was right there in line?
In 1973, Larry Holmes turns professional. This is his first fight filmed with an 8mm camera. 5 years and 26 wins later, Holmes defeats a top contender, Ernie Shavers, thus setting the stage for a championship bout.
After beating Ernie Shavers, it became very clear that it was possible for you to become the world heavyweight champion. How did you feel about that?
Well, I felt good about it because it had given me the opportunity to prove to all my critics that Larry Holmes had the potential, the capability to become a heavyweight champion of the world. They said I was a common copy of Muhammad Ali. I couldn't punch. My legs were too small. Just a common copy of Muhammad Ali. And I couldn't take a punch. And when I took Shaver's punches, that put me right in that position to fight for the title with Kenny Norton. And, you know, when I fought Kenny Norton, the odds was high. I was underdog, of course.
This has been round 15. Larry Holmes and Kenny Norton for the heavyweight championship of the world. It has been a tough, bruising battle right from the opening bell. 30 seconds left to go in this fight. And they continue to pound and go toe-to-toe. Look at the courage of Larry Holmes as he tries to gain the heavyweight championship of the world. Continues to throw that right hand and land on Kenny Norton. Norton covering up, trying to fight back. Less than 10 seconds to go in the fight. Both fighters are exhausted, but they continue to throw punches. Incredible courage being shown as we come to the final bell. What a fight for the heavyweight championship of the world. Larry Holmes being mobbed in the ring. It's a close fight and a close decision. And right now, let's go into the ring and find out the decision.
He had a split decision. Dutch Joe Swissel scores it 143-142 for the new
Larry Holmes has won a split decision in a tremendous fight, and we have a new heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Holmes.
That particular fight proved to be one of the greatest fights in the history of boxing.
That's what they told me.
Oh, you don't think so?
I don't want to remember that fight.
Oh.
Because it was that bad of a fight. It was a great fight. We both stood toe-to-toe, and we gave it all. We gave it our all. And just the other day, Jose Silliman, the WBC president, had named that fight the second greatest fight in 20 years after the Ali and Frazier fight.
The Thriller in Manila.
Thriller in Manila.
Pressures on a world heavyweight. Do you find that it's difficult to maintain what Rocky, Sylvester Stallone, would call that eye of the tiger?
A lot of fighters lose the eye, if you want to call the eye of the tiger, when they go out and do a lot of things at night and when they don't really practice or what their trade is. I practice my trade. My trade is boxing. I practice boxing. Nightlife comes later after my boxing career is over. But right now, boxing's number one. And so I don't think I will lose it. And when I do lose it, it's time for me to quit, because that's a sign of taking too many and having too much.
On June 22nd, 1979, Larry Holmes defends his title against muscular Mike Weaver, a relatively unknown fighter. As the fight reaches the 11th round, a weary Larry Holmes knows his title is in jeopardy.
Larry Holmes comes out. He looks like weary. Mike Weaver comes out to meet him and starts fast. Weaver throwing punches and backing up Larry Holmes. Weaver landing. 45 seconds to go in round 11. Larry Holmes looking really tired here.
During the fight, Mike Weaver hit me from one corner to another corner and blackened both of my eyes, twisted my jaw, perforated my eardrums. Man, I don't want this to happen to me.
Holmes seems to be fighting and throwing punches on instinct alone. Weaver measuring Larry Holmes. Weaver looking for that big punch, looking to throw the right hand, and lands with the right hand. And there's a big uppercut by Larry Holmes, and Weaver goes down. Weaver is hurt. A big right uppercut by Larry Holmes landed right on the chin of Mike Weaver. He struggles to get up. He's up at the count of eight. What a turnaround in this fight. We're in round 12, and now it's Larry Holmes hurting Mike Weaver, has him backed up against the ropes, measuring him for that right hand, and he bombs with the right hand again. Weaver is hurt, and the referee steps in and stops the fight. It's all over. Larry Holmes has stopped Mike Weaver. The fight is stopped at 2:16 of the 12th round, and Larry Holmes retains the heavyweight.
The Ernie Shavers rematch came up shortly after that. Talk about that fight.
Well, and Ernie is my friend. Ernie and I, we still have a strong relationship. And I was banging around after the third round. His eye was kind of like hanging out. And I was saying to him, man, don't keep taking this. I said, you can't keep taking this. And he said, shut up and fight. I'm going to knock you out. I'm going to take that title. So I would box and box and bang him a little bit. I look at the referee and the ref wouldn't stop it. And in the seventh round, I got kind of careless. That when lightning struck.
We're in the seventh round. Shavers going after the champion, Larry Holmes. A big right hand by Ernie Shavers, and Larry Holmes is down. The champion struggles to his feet. Shavers looks confident, and now he's trying.
I was like a basketball. He hit me so hard, I hit the canvas, and I bounced straight back up. Didn't know where I were, though.
Larry Holmes does survive the seventh round, having taken the best from Ernie Shavers. With the heart of a champion, Holmes comes back to take charge of the fight. And in the 11th round, his title is retained.
Well, after you beat Shavers, because you did go on to win the fight, and then there were a couple of more victories, and then you find yourself meeting truly a legend and your hero and a personal friend of yours, very good friend of yours, Muhammad Ali. How confident were you?
So confident I had spent all my money. No, age can't beat you. And Ali at that time was over the hill. you know, I would say. And that's something that happens to all of us. We just got to know when it's time to quit. Ali knew when it was time to quit, but yet money brought him back.
There's Ali leading the chant. Ali, Ali. There's the champion, Larry Holmes, looking in great shape. And there's the bell for round one. Holmes comes out quickly.
While some may feel that Ali looks the same, it is just an illusion. Before too long, Larry Holmes shows the world that Ali is merely a shadow of his old self.
And Ali covers up as Holmes throws the left hook. And Holmes pulls Ali against the ropes. Larry Holmes looking very strong early in the fight. This is round 10, and a tired and battered Muhammad Ali struggles out of the corner, looking like a shell of his old self. 7 seconds to go in the round. Holmes continues to pound Ali. That's the end of round 10. And let's go into Ali's corner.
Check it out.
The whole game's over.
I'm in 3 seconds.
All right.
I stopped the fight.
And mercifully, Angelo Dundee has stopped the fight. Larry Holmes has won, and he goes over.
By beating Ali, helped me out a lot. You know, I think people recognize me for me. Because I've been a good champion. I haven't gotten tickets for speeding. I haven't beaten up anybody in the bars. I haven't been in jail. And I think that's a good image for a fighter, for a champion.
Career, there's been a feeling that Larry Holmes has not been truly appreciated, given his just due. How would you explain that?
Well, I had a long road to follow, a long haul to follow, because I had to follow a great guy, you know, Muhammad Ali. You know, sometimes these things happen to fighters and like Joe Louis and Dempsey and Marciano. I just had Muhammad Ali to follow, and it's a hell of an act to follow.
How do you think you fared?
I think now I come out of it okay. I mean, but one time it really looked gloomy. The cloud was over me all the time. Everywhere I went, the cloud was over me. But that cloud has been removed.
Well, after you beat Ali, you then fought Leon Spinks. What about that fight?
Didn't like Leon. Leon made some statements, made some passes at my wife. And I kind of had it out for him, but I had it out for him not enough to hurt him, but just to do him in, so get him out of the way.
Holmes has Spinks on the ropes here in round 3. Larry Holmes teeing off on Leon Spinks with that right hand. Spinks is hurt and ready to go, trying to duck away from the right hand. And down the go! A right hand sends Leon Spinks down to the canvas. He's struggling to get up, trying to beat the count. Larry Holmes comes out. He's back on the attack here. Holmes trying to finish off Leon Spinks. Spinks covering up in the corner. He can't get away from the right hands of Larry Holmes. Holmes measuring Leon Spinks, landing that right hand time and again. It's all Larry Holmes. There's the right again. Spinks is helpless in the corner. And the referee trying to step in and stops the fight. It's all over. Larry Holmes has won on a TKO in the 3rd round.
After the fight, Holmes becomes involved in a scuffle of a different kind.
There's another young man in this arena tonight. His name is Jerry Cooney.
Howard.
And you want him.
I'm going to slap his face and bring him over here. And I don't even want to talk about it, Cooney. And tell you, put his name on the contract. You come over here,
we're going to
fight right now.
Come on.
Come on.
You know, that was my show. That was my night. I fought the fight. If they want to interview Jerry Cooney or whatever, do it after I'm finished. He never fought anybody, was rated in the top 10 before he fought the heavyweight championship fight. And then he had to get parity. He got $10 million to fight me when he didn't deserve it. So everybody wants Jerry Cooney to be a hero or Rocky or whatever, but that day is never going to come. They better start looking for someone else.
Larry Holmes staring straight ahead at Jerry Cooney.
Cooney looking down away from the champ as the referee gives the instructions to the two fighters. Larry Holmes says good fight and heads back into his corner, and we're ready to go. Jerry Cooney, the number one contender, going against the champion Larry Holmes. Jerry Cooney has become the white hope, and Larry seems to resent it. There's the bell. Second round action. Holmes up on his toes. And a good right hand.
Heavyweight champion, Larry Holmes continues to meet every challenge. In 1982, Randall Tex Cobb challenges Mr. Holmes. Is completely one-sided as Holmes' boxing skills prove to be too much for Tex Cobb. Cobb's face tells the story. In June of 1983, Holmes meets another challenger by the name of Tim Witherspoon. 10 years younger than Holmes, Witherspoon takes the champ the distance in a hard-fought fight. The winner will be decided by a split decision, and Holmes' undefeated record is in jeopardy.
The deciding ballot cast by Chuck Minker, 115 Holmes, 113 Tim Witherspoon, winner and still the heavyweight champion, Larry Holmes.
Next, Larry Holmes meets Marvis Frazier, the son of former champ Joe Frazier. Result is another win for Larry Holmes. In 45 fights, he has never lost. After being the champion for over 5 years, Holmes is considering retirement.
Do you think that after retirement, it might be possible that someone would tempt you to come back into the game?
For $50 million. To fight Jerry Looney Cooney.
Well, Larry Holmes, I don't have any doubt. I know a whole bunch of people that don't have doubt, and you've proven it over and over again. You are a sports legend, and you are truly one of the greatest of all times.
Thank you. I don't know about all time, but this time, yes.
Thank you for being with us today.